In the previous video, we have discussed section 36 and 37 of the Transfer of Prperty Act 1882. If you have not seen the previous video, I have provided the link in the description box which you can watch it afterward. In this video, we are going to study section 41 of the Transfer of Prperty Act which deals with transfer by ostensible owner. Transfer by ostensible owner. Under section 41 of the Transfer of Prperty Act, where with the consent, express or implied, of the persons interested in immovable property, a person is the ostensible owner of such property, and transfer the same for consideration, the transfer shall not be voidable on the ground that the transfer was not authorized to make it. Provided that the transferee, after taking reasonable care to ascertain that the transferor had power to make the transfer, had acted in good faith. Thus, this section deals with the transfer of property by an ostensible owner, that is, who is not the real owner. The general rule is that all ostensible owners cannot pass a good title to the transferee. But if the conditions laid down in the section are fulfilled, the transfer shall not be voidable on the ground that the transferor was not authorized to make it. This section is therefore an exception to the general rule that a person cannot confer a better title than he himself has in the property transferred. Thus, the section requires the following condition for its application. Number 1. The transferor is an ostensible owner. Number 2. He is so by the consent, express or implied, of the real owner. Number 3. The transfer is for consideration. Number 4. The transferee has acted in good faith and has taken reasonable care to find out that the transferor had the power to transfer. Thus, section 41 says that, number 1, where, with the consent, either express or implied, of the person interested in immovable property, number 2, a person is the ostensible owner of such property, and number 3, transfer the same for consideration, the transfer is not voidable on the ground that the transfer was not authorized to make it. However, in such a case, it is necessary that the transferee, after taking reasonable care to ascertain that the transferor had power to make the transfer, must act in good faith. An ostensible owner is one who has all the indicia of ownership without being the real owner. This expression therefore excludes such person who holds possession of property professedly as agent, guardian, or in any other fiduciary character. A guardian of a minor cannot be said to be ostensible owner of the minor's property, as a minor cannot give consent. On the other hand, a benamider is an ostensible owner, and if a person purchases from a benamider, the real owner cannot recover, provided other conditions are fulfilled. Thus, the rule enunciated in this section is an exception of the general rule that a person cannot convey a better title than he himself has in the property. The general rule of law of transfer of property is that no man can transfer to another a right or title greater than what he himself possesses. In a case law in Ramkumar Kundu versus McQueen, it was observed that it is a principle of natural equity which must be universally applicable, that where one man allows another to hold himself out as the owner of an estate, and a third person purchases it for value from the apparent owner in the belief that he is the real owner, the man who so allows the other to hold himself out shall not be permitted to recover upon his secret title, unless he can overthrow that of the purchaser by showing either that he had direct notice of the title or something which amounts to constructive notice of the real owner, or that there existed circumstances which ought to have put him into an inquiry that, if prosecuted, would have led to a discovery of it. Ingredients of Section 41. The following are the ingredients of Section 41. Number 1. The transferor must be the ostensible owner of the property, with the consent, express or implied, of the person interested in the property. Number 2. The transfer must be for consideration. Number 3. The transferee must take reasonable care to ascertain that the transferor has power to make the transfer and must act in good faith. In order to attract the operation of Section 41, the party relying upon the section must establish all these ingredients. If any one of these essentials be wanting, the transferee is not entitled to protection. Thus, we have completed Section 41 of the Transfer of Prperty Act 1882. Hope this video will be useful to you. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.